Hi, on this different kind of Easter, we want to take you back to a classic service in 1989. You may see some folks you remember as the service starts. And then after the opening part of the hour, some young people will present a meaningful and powerful musical called Watch the Lamb. The singers will be April Jackson Moore, Misty Schubert, Sarah Ummel, Kim Sutton Brown, and Joshua Potts, all age 14, and Chris Jackson, age 12, and Charles McGinnis, age 18. Thank you for joining us for this Safe at Home Easter Sunday. After the opening part of the hour, let's watch the Lamb. Happy to welcome you tonight, and we thank you so much for coming. This is just what we'd hoped for, and it's great. We found this musical right after Easter was over. That would have been a good time to have had it. It's so good we couldn't keep it till another Easter rolled around, and so the kids got it ready, and we decided to go for it tonight. It's the greatest story ever told. And we think tonight your heart is going to be thrilled and God is going to be glorified as we watch the Lamb. Let's bow for prayer, please. Father, we pray now that you'll take all the hours of preparation, turn it into something that lives, so that our hearts will be moved as never before, and we'll understand just how much it cost to redeem a lost man or woman or lad or lass. Thank you for this beautiful story. May we tell it as you would have us to. Sharpen our skills, quicken our minds, and as we combine to tell the story, may it be pleasing to the audience. God, we stand together to praise the Lamb
on this night, and we pray that your name will be exalted through Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. Amen.
This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. That's what our story will be about later, and that's what we're going to sing about now. Will you turn to number 317, Blessed Assurance, and let's sing all three verses, please.
This offering is just that. It's going to be used for our young people who have so distinguished themselves over the past year by attendance and faithfulness and participation, all of whom are in this ensemble tonight, plus another 14 or 16. And this offering tonight will be used for their trip to Washington, D.C. So I thought you might like to know that it had a special meaning. If you've given for the day, fine. Just sit down and get your heart ready to watch the Lamb. Let's have another brief moment of prayer, please. Eldon, would you lead us, please?
Our Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this day. Thank you for the beautiful service and the great message that we had this morning. Pray now that this thought may carry on through tonight and go with us throughout our lives. Make this service special, Father, just by making us aware of your presence here. And may the offerings we bring indicate that we are aware of the great sacrifice made for us. Let's take these offerings now, Father, bless them, and use them to further your work in some way. In Jesus' name we ask it.
Thank you. You may be seated.
add my welcome to the one you got earlier. And I'll have to be honest with you, I didn't expect half this many people tonight. I'm thankful to God that you came to share this night with us. Because tonight, we are going to share a very special musical program. It's different from anything we've ever done before. It is intensely moving, and its purpose is simply to drive home one profound biblical truth, that our atonement comes at a very high cost. Again and again, God drew pictures for his people to help them understand that man's sins could be covered only by the shed blood of the innocent lamb. The lamb had to die. Our story takes place at the time of Passover, the Jewish holiday celebrating the deliverance of the Hebrews from slavery in ancient Egypt. You will remember that the death angel passed over the families who had put the blood of the lamb on the doorposts and above the door of their homes. As our story begins, a Jewish father decides that his two sons are now old enough to really understand the meaning of Passover. This is the year they will make the journey to Jerusalem to take part in this special event and to offer their lamb as a sacrifice for remission of sins. On the trip, the father keeps reminding the boys that it is their job to watch the lamb. It just happens that their visit coincides with the arrival of Jesus into Jerusalem on Palm Sunday. Before the week is over, the father ends up playing a very unexpected role, and the boys learn an unforgettable lesson about the lamb. When you leave here tonight, I hope that you will understand the lesson that they learned, that the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world is the very Son of God. So come with us now, and together, let's watch the Lamb.
To Jerusalem with his two sons. They had journeyed a very long way. Now they were entering the southern hill country of Judea.
Beside you on the road, the reason they came.
and a loud, mischievous voice. The young lad was named Alexander, and his head was full of dreams and sunshine. Every so often, Alexander would stop and wait for a lamb he was leading to come and nuzzle its head against his arm. The lamb was named Methuselah. We'll rest here tonight, boys. Tomorrow we'll sleep within the walls of Jerusalem. Rufus, seeing a chore coming, spoke first. Dad, Alexander's not carried his share all day long. I think he ought to have to gather the firewood tonight. That's not fair, a little voice chimed. Rufus is bigger than me. And anyway, I gotta take care of Methuselah. I told you not to give that lamb a name, boy. He's not a pet. Now, no more calling that animal by name. Do you understand? Okay, Dad. I won't call Methuselah any name ever again as long as I live. Right, Methuselah? The father knew that trying to separate the boy and the lamb had been a losing battle from the very start. Later, after wood had been collected and Methuselah fed, the family gathered around a crackling fire. Each night, since they left home, the father had been telling them stories of their ancestors of long ago. Tonight was a night for a very special story about another father and his son. Boys, it was in these very hills, 2,000 years ago, that Abraham came with his little boy, Isaac. God had commanded him to go to the mountains of Moriah to make a sacrifice in worship. Rufus, having been to synagogue school, spoke up. I know all about that, Dad. The mountain where Abraham and Isaac went is supposed to be the very place where the temple stands today. That's where they went to make the sacrifice. Alexander had his hand up. But what were they going to sacrifice? Did they take a young bull or some doves with them or what? Don't you know anything, little brother? Abraham was going to sacrifice Isaac. He was going to the mountain to sacrifice his own son. Alexander looked frightened and confused. Was not. Dad, tell Mr. Know-it-all, that's not true. The father could only reach out and take his young son's hand. But it is the truth, Alexander. God had commanded Abraham to take his son Isaac and to sacrifice him. Then Abraham must not have loved his little boy as much as you love me, huh, Daddy? He loved him as much as any father ever loved his son, Alexander. He loved him when he led him up the side of that mountain. He loved him when he laid him on the altar. He even loved him when he lifted his knife into the air above his helpless, wonderful little boy. Alexander's face was now marked by two lines of tears. He finally whispered, "But what was he thinking, Dad?" He was thinking how much it cost us when we really love someone very much.
All of these years I've waited and prayed for this child I see. Can you tell me somehow what to say to as he looks up at me? don't understand. God will provide the land.
And at that very moment, the father continued, at that very moment, just as Abraham held his knife up in his trembling hand, suddenly an angel of the Lord spoke. Abraham, the voice thundered, now I know that you love me more than any other thing. Do not take the life of your son, Isaac. The boys around the campfire cheered. Rufus jumped to his feet, and Alexander was hugging a rather confused and sleepy Methuselah. Alexander finally said, I knew God would come through in the end. And Abraham heard a noise and looked up the hillside, and there was a wild mountain ram trapped in a bush. God had provided a different sacrifice to take the place of Isaac. Rufus was still clapping. That's great, Dad. Not for the poor ram. Alexander was not clapping. He had stopped. He was holding Methuselah tightly. Then the father put his hand on his young son and on the little lamb that they had brought with them from home. No, Alexander, not for the ram. Who cares about an old ram, Dad? I think it's great. I can just see Isaac and his dad running back down that mountain. What a time they must have had.
Ages old creation monstrously would provide. Every nation song of salvation, God was glorified.
Then his children called upon him, helpless and afraid.
With a mighty hand of deliverance,
he was sent to save.
Sunny. The boys and their dad had packed up early and had walked all morning with almost no time taken for rest. They were too eager to stop or even slow down. They were going to Jerusalem. They climbed a long hill, and when they reached the top of it, they suddenly stopped. The boys stood frozen. And the father knelt down and put his arms around both of them as they stared off toward the horizon. Alexander was the first to say something. Is that it, Dad? Is that Jerusalem? The city of David? The city where God will live? Yes, son. The city of the hope of all our people everywhere. And now, we will be celebrating Passover in the very city of David and Solomon and Rehoboam and Jeremiah. I only wish your mother could have been here. We dreamed of the day when we could take you boys and go to the city of our fathers. Rufus finally found his voice again. And that's where Messiah is going to come, isn't it, Dad? He's going to walk right in and sit down right on the throne of David, huh? Yes, Rufus. He will come one day and set our people free. A second Moses, even greater than Moses himself. Yeah, Rufus went on. Then the Romans will wish they'd never seen Judea. Messiah will crush them like wheat under a millstone, huh? Alexander's voice chimed in. That's not what I think Messiah is going to be like. Oh yeah, Alexander, what do you know? What do you think Messiah is going to be like? Oh, I know he'll be a king and a warrior and a judge and a savior. Alexander brought Methuselah close to himself. But I think most of all, Messiah is going to be gentle, like a lamb.
Messiah would come, the earth would rejoice, the people start to sing. For they would behold, as scripture foretold, a mighty King of Kings. But he came as a child, not like they had planned, not like they planned. Could this
The father and his boys are now in the middle of the thousands of travelers moving toward the entrance of the city called the Golden Gate. They had come through a small village called Bethany, and now they were in the middle of a great teeming crowd of people. Everywhere, children were laughing and men were holding palms of victory high into the air. Rufus yelled to his dad above all the noise, "Dad, look at all those people." "I know, son. Isn't it wonderful? Passover is the busiest time of the year. Our people come here from every corner of the world. Now hold your palm branches high in the air. They stand for victory and peace." Suddenly, a new set of cries and shouts could be heard back behind them. The father and the two boys stopped, along with those around them, to listen to the commotion. Some people further back began to run back, away from the city, back up the road toward Bethany. The boys tugged at their father's cloak with frantic questions. "I don't know, boys, but there seems to be something happening. There's a huge crowd going back toward Bethany." Rufus suddenly grabbed his father by the arm. "Listen, Dad. Listen. Did you hear it? Somebody over there shouted the word, Messiah." "He's right, Dad. They are. They are. Come on, Dad. What are we waiting for? We want to be there to welcome the Messiah." And among all the shouts and cheers of hosannas that went up that bright Sunday afternoon were the voices of a father, two very excited boys, and one little lamb.
"Have you heard about Jesus? He's coming this way. Have you heard all the things he has done? The deaf ear can hear, the blind eye can see, even the lame man can run.
Sing it, shout it, tell everyone that you know. He is coming to Jerusalem. Let all the children sing. Glory to the Prince of Peace. Hosanna to the King. Did you know the Messiah? He's coming today. He's nearing the edge of the town. And when he gets here, all the people will cheer. Them and the children around. Sing it, shout it, tell everyone that you know. He is coming to Jerusalem. Let all the children sing. Glory to the Prince of Peace. Hosanna to He is coming to Jerusalem. Let all the children sing. Glory to the Prince of Peace. Hosanna.
And that night, Rufus and Alexander and their father slept within the walls of the city of Jerusalem. All that week, they heard rumors and stories about the man they had seen briefly on Sunday and cheered as the Messiah. But mostly, they walked about the city, looking at all the sights. They visited the great temple and saw the craftsmen still working in the outer court. The great temple had been started under wicked King Herod long before most of the people around them had even been born. The family listened to the singing of the choirs and the reading of the law and the prophets. The days passed quickly, too quickly, especially for Alexander and Methuselah. Then, late one afternoon, Alexander's father walked into the little stall where the boy was feeding Methuselah. It was the day Alexander had never wanted to even talk about. It was the eve of Passover. The father stood for a long time watching. "Alexander, it's time, son." The boy did not even look up. He just kept brushing the back of the lamp. Dad, can I have a little more time to feed him? Please? Just this one last time. All right, son. Just a few minutes. You know where Methuselah has to be at sundown, Alexander. The boy reached into a leather pouch. He tried hard not to let the lamb see the tears in his eyes. Here, boy. Take some of my bread. I'm not very hungry. You'll be okay, Methuselah. It won't hurt much, I promise. Don't be too mad at Dad, boy. He's just doing what God says. You know? We need the blood of a lamb for Passover. Try and understand, Methuselah. We both got to try real hard and understand.
I know.
Disciples, bread, body, cup, blood, remember, garden, waiting, alone, praying, hurting, afraid. Mine, yours, torches, soldiers, friend, kiss, betrayed. Questions, silence, mockings, silence, beatings, silence, Pilate, priest, innocent, crucify, innocent. Crucify soldiers, scourging, anguish, man, cross, Golgotha.
sons. Walk beside me on the road. The reason that they came was to watch the lamb. Daddy, daddy, what will we see there?
Lord, I placed it on my shoulder and started. They led us to Golgotha. They drove nails deep in his feet and hands. And yet upon the cross I heard him pray, Father, forgive them.
Worthy is the Lamb. to him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be blessing and honor and glory and dominion forever and forever.
Stayed in Jerusalem for the Feast of Weeks. Rufus grew up, moved to Rome, and became a leader of those who followed Christ. And what about Alexander? Well, he never quite got over losing Methuselah, the lamb that ran away. But he still likes to have animals around him. And even though he's grown, he still likes to get a crowd around on a spring night and tell them about the time he and his father and his brother watched the Lamb of God. He never gets tired of telling that story. Tonight, you have watched the Lamb. Perhaps it has reached your heart. Could be that for the first time, you've really seen what it cost. But do you realize, my friend, you are the lamb that got away. There was a reprieve for little Methuselah. There was no reprieve for the Son of God. Except for him, you and I would have to die. Because of him, we shall live forever. If you came here tonight and you didn't know him, but you've met him, since you came. And if you're not ashamed of him, and if you are willing to say, I'll follow him, we want to give you that opportunity. We're going to sing a verse of a song you know very well. O Lamb of God, I come. Would you please stand? And while we sing, it's 260 if you should need it, but the lights will stay off. While we sing, if you've never known Christ as the Lamb of God, and you might even be a member of the church, but you don't know him, then the greatest experience you'll ever have can be yours in the next few moments. O Lamb of God, I come. Will you stand with us, please? One last time, and then that will close this invitation. Just hum it from your heart, please. Christian service, thanking our Heavenly Father for giving us His Son. We understand now how much it cost you, how much it hurt, but also how much you love us. Thank you for these who have told the story. And these who go now and tell it to others. In Christ's dear name, amen. Lights will come on and you've got time to visit with one another, but this concludes Watch the Lamb. Thank you for coming.
Good job, guys.